name pops into your head? Now, right over here, guys, behind us is this blue hole. A blue hole is a karst window that basically means that there's an underground river that makes an above ground appearance at this point. There are 4 blue holes on our property and 7 blue holes in the Lost River. Now, the Lost River's going up and down a lot. Look at that cart bed that we talked about. Now everyone, this is the largest cave entrance this side of the Mississippi River. It's approximately 150 feet wide and 100 feet from top to bottom. And it's housed several different operations. In 1792, by the name of Mr. Shanks opened up a saw and brick mill right in the entrance of our cave there. And what Mr. Shanks didn't know was that we're the drainage basin for over 55 square miles. And every time the surface gets an inch of rain, our water level down here can raise 8 to 10. This mill got flooded several times and got washed back into the cave before he finally decided to call it quits. Had rock and roll music come into town. The owners thought that was the devil's music and they were not going to book any of those acts at their nightclub. People didn't want to hear jazzy swing anymore. Lastly, air conditioning was invented. We're no longer the coolest place in town. And we shut our doors in 1962. At that time, we entered a dark chapter in the history of the Lost River Cave. It became the largest illegal dumping site in Bowling Green. People would drive their vehicles up 31W. You guys, on this side over here, I need you to squish down just a little bit.
Squish
down. Like your neighbor, we gotta get one more on that side, okay?
We gotta get one more person on this side.
Make sure it's a heavy line, okay?
They forgot to dry that seat off while you're on. That's why I need y'all to scoot.
It's not hard to walk out though.
Now guys, over here to my left, we have our flowstone.
Ooh, look at the pretty rock.
It is the largest formation on our shore today. And unlike the rest of the cave, it's not being eroded by the water that flows over it. The water that flows over our flowstone here is rich in a mineral called calcite. Now that calcite gets deposited on the rock and it'll grow a millimeter a year.
That one here is the one that's going to fall tomorrow.
That just depends on how much rainfall we get. You'll see that green part up there, that's algae, caused by our lights. Unfortunately, the lights that we have in our cave cause us to grow in here and the process. Stalactite growth actually depends on the amount of rain an area needs. So if we have a lot of rain, it's going to grow a lot faster than if we have a drought. Where my light's shining right now is the largest stalactite on our tour.
It's
called the upside down praying hands.
It sure does look like me.